சார் வந்து பார்த்தீங்கன்னா நம்ம அமிர்தா காலேஜில் சிஎஸ்சி டிபார்ட்மெண்ட்டுடைய ப்ரொஃபஸராக இருக்காங்க. இந்தியாவில் ஒரு இந்தியாவில் வந்து நிறைய இனிஷியேட்டிவ்ஸ், அவங்க காலேஜில் வேரியஸ் ஹேக்கத்தான் ப்ரோக்ராம்ஸ், இந்தியாவில் நடக்கிற நிறைய ஹேக்கத்தான் ப்ரோக்ராம்ஸை அவர் கைட் பண்ணி ஸ்டூடெண்ட்ஸ் வந்து நிறைய பேர் வந்து வின் பண்ணியிருக்காங்க. சிங்கப்பூரில் நடந்த ஹேக்கத்தான், அது மாதிரி நிறைய நிறையா ஈவெண்ட்ஸ் வந்து நம்ம லிஸ்ட் பண்ணிட்டே போகலாம். ப்ளஸ் வந்து இந்தியாவுடைய பிளானிங் கமிஷன் சொல்லக்கூடிய நித்தி ஆயோக் கேள்விப்பட்டிருப்பீங்க. நித்தி ஆயோக்ல ஒரு அந்த பிளானிங் கமிஷன் டீம்ல வந்து சார் வந்து ஒன் ஆஃப் தி மெம்பராக இருக்காங்க. அண்ட் மோர் ஓவர் நம்ம அட்டல் இனோவேஷன் மிஷன் கவர்மெண்ட் சென்ட்ரல் கவர்மெண்ட் ஒரு ஸ்கீம் வந்து லான்ச் பண்ணியிருக்காங்க. இது மூலமா நம்ம ஸ்கூல்ஸ் இருக்கு இல்லைங்களா, ஸ்கூல்ல வந்து அட்டல் டிங்கரிங் லேப்ஸ், அட்டல் டிங்கரிங் லேப் வந்து இனிஷியேட் பண்ணி அதில் ஸ்கூல் ஸ்டூடெண்ட்ஸ்க்கு ரோபோட்டிக்ஸ் பற்றி ஆர்டிஃபிஷியல் இன்டெலிஜென்ஸ் பற்றி ட்ரைனிங் கொடுத்துட்டு இருக்காங்க. இப்போ கரண்ட்டாக நிறையா ஸ்கூல்ஸ் வந்து தமிழ்நாட்டில் வந்து ஆல் ஓவர் இந்தியா வந்து ஜாயின் பண்ணியிருக்காங்க. சார் வந்து அட்டல் இனோவேஷன் மிஷனுடைய அட்டல் மென்டர் ஆஃப் சேஞ்ச்னு ஒரு ஒரு ஃபேக்கல்டிஸ் யார் வேணாலும் ஹூ அவர் இன்ட்ரெஸ்டட் டு ட்ரெயின் த ஸ்கூல்ஸ் சில்ட்ரன்ஸ் இன் அஸ் அ சர்வீஸ் தே கேன் ஜாயின். சரிங்களா, சார் வந்து ஒரு ரீஜினல் ஒரு அட்டல் மென்டர் ஆஃப் சேஞ்சாக ஜாயின் பண்ணிவிட்டு இப்போ வந்து தமிழ்நாடுடைய ரீஜினல் மென்டர் ஆஃப் சேஞ்சாக இருக்காங்க. ஸோ ஆப்வியஸாக இந்த செஷனில் உங்களுக்கு வந்து நிறைய இன்புட் கிடைக்கும். ஒரு ஹேக்கத்தான் எப்படி வின் பண்ணுறது, எப்படி ஒரு ப்ராஜெக்டை பிளான் பண்ணுறது, எப்படி வந்து நம்ம ஹவு வி கேன் க்ரோ, நம்மளுடைய ஃபீல்டில் நம்ம எப்படி வளருதுன்றதுல உங்களுக்கு நிறைய இன்புட் கிடைக்கும். ஐ ரெக்வஸ்ட் எவ்ரி ஒன் டு ப்ரெசன்ட் இந்த செஷன். செஷன் முடிகிற வரைக்கும் எல்லோரும் செஷனில் இருக்குங்கன்னு ரெக்வஸ்ட் பண்ணிக்கிறோம். பேரலாக ப்ளீஸ் ட்ரை டு ரைஸ் க்வெஸ்டின்ஸ். அவரோட செஷன் இன்ட்ராக்டிவாக இருந்தால் கண்டிப்பாக விரும்புவாங்க இந்த மாதிரி பர்சன்ஸ். ஸோ கண்டிப்பாக அவங்க கொஸ்டின் அண்ட் ஆன்சர் செஷன் வரும்பொழுது ஆப்வியஸாக இதில் எல்லாருக்குமே ஹேக்கத்தான்ற ஒரு விஷயத்தை நீ வரக்கூடிய நாட்கள் செகண்ட் இயராக இருந்தாலும் தேர்ட் இயராக இருந்தாலும் யூ கோயிங் டு ஃபேஸ் ரைட். ஸோ அது ரிலேட்டடாக ஓகே, எங்களுடைய ப்ராஜெக்ட் ரிலேட்டடாக ஓகே, வாட் எவர் யூ வாண்டட் டு ஆஸ்க், ஃபீல் ஃப்ரீ டு ஸ்பீக் வித். ரொம்ப ஒரு ஸ்போர்ட்டிவாக, ரொம்ப வந்து ஸ்டூடெண்ட்ஸ் கிட்ட வந்து நல்லா ஃப்ரெண்ட்லியாக பேசக்கூடிய ஒரு பர்சன். சரிங்களா, ஸோ ப்ளீஸ் ட்ரை டு ஸ்டே இன் திஸ் செஷன் அண்டில் தி என்டையர் செஷன் கெட்ஸ் ஓவர். ஓகே, இப்போ சார் ஜாயின் பண்ணிடுவாங்க. ஸோ வி ஸ்டார்ட் தி செஷன் ஆஸ் சூன் அஸ் பாசிபிள். சார் வெரி குட் மார்னிங் சார். ஹலோ சார், சார் யூ ஆர் நாட் ஆடிபிள் சார்.
கமிங் கமிங், ஆர் யூ, அம் ஐ ஆடிபிள் நவ?
எஸ் சார், யூ ஆர் ஆடிபிள் ரைட் நவ் சார். எஸ் சார்,
ஓகே ஓகே.
Shall we start the session, sir?
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Please, yeah, no problem. Sure.
Okay, sir. Good morning, everyone. A warm welcome to one and all for this wonderful session on how to win a hackathon by our honorable resource person of the day, Dr. Prashant R. Nair. I feel very happy to introduce you about our resource person of today's event. Dr. Prashant R. Nair is working as an associate professor of computer science and engineering and coordinator of internal quality assurance cell of Amrita School of Engineering, Amrita Vishwavidyapeetham, Coimbatore campus, India. He has 27 years of teaching, research, mentoring, training, consultancy and academic administration experience at the Amrita University. He is very passionate about contributing to the innovation ecosystem of the country through student initiatives and outreach. He has mentored student teams which have won premier international and national competitions like Smart India Hackathon, Rajasthan Hackathon, TCS Digital Twin Challenge, SciLab Hackathon, and represented India as part of the national hackathon team for Singapore India Hackathon and facilitated by our Honorable Prime Minister of India, Sri Narendra Modi. He also be ranked as top innovation mentor in India by Atal Innovation Mission and currently coordinates AIM, Atal Innovation Mission Activities at Tamil Nadu as Regional Mentor of Change. So through this session, through this Regional Mentor of Change, they are addressing various, many thousands of students from schools all over Tamil Nadu and all over India. So they are training, SAR is training students as in the field of robotics, in the field of artificial intelligence, in the field of engineering. They are teaching the what the students should do in their engineering from their school itself. So we can definitely see the change when these students come into a college. We can definitely see the drift of the current engineering system, where we can see the real output from the engineering students in the upcoming years. And about his publications and book, he has published around 6 books and 2 edited books, 1 book chapter and 40 plus research publications in leading journals. He has published many papers, like 12 scopus listed, which also includes 6 high H index papers and 5 I-10 index, of which with 150 citations in Google Scholar. His area of interest includes applications of ICT tools for supply chain management, management information systems, cyber security, and business analytics. I extend my hearty welcome to you, sir, and I definitely hope our students will get a brief knowledge, a brief experience in traveling with you. Thank you, sir. All the session is over with you, sir.
Yeah. Thank you, Professor Dinesh Prabhu. Actually, at the outset, I want to congratulate this institution's innovation cell of Karpagam Institutions, Karpagam Institute of Technology, under the leadership of Dinesh. I understand you got 5 stars, and I congratulate you on the various multifarious activities that you have been doing for the IAIC. I think the IAIC institution's innovation cell is a very important revolutionary concept that the Ministry of Education has started, and I'm sure that we are going to see the results, whether it is in terms of increased participation in Smart India Hackathon or Drug Discovery Hackathon and so on. So many things are actually happening, and the idea is the IAIC can dovetail all these activities. I'm also a member of our colleges, our universities, IAIC, and I see the activities are moving from strength to strength. While wishing you, so I'm going to just give a kind of an experiential lecture on how to win a hackathon. See, this is just my personal experiences, my personal sharing of best practices. It may not be at a very highly technical level, or it may not be that kind of rocket science or something. It's a very simple, commonsensical things that we have used for winning so many hackathons, and that's the only thing I'm going to cover. So there is nothing highly technical about it or nothing. It's just our our experiences and our best practices that I'm sharing with you. I'll just share my slides in a minute. Just give me a minute. Yes. Is the slide visible?
Yes, sir. It is visible, sir.
The slide is visible, right?
Yes, sir, it is visible, sir.
Yes. This is a very short lecture. I'll probably spend more time answering your queries. If you have any. So basically, some of the experiences that I gained in the last 5 years, I have been actively mentoring students for hackathons and competitions and contests. Last 5 years, perhaps from 2016 onwards, I've been very, not 5 years, it's basically 4 years. 2017 onwards only, I've been very actively mentoring students for hackathons and contests, because till then, I have been holding a lot of administrative work. People know me mostly for, NAC, NARF, MBA, all over the community, the country, people know for that, he's well reputed in NAC, NARF, MBA. So that was generally my calling card. But last 3-4 years, I've been very actively involved in this, and the results are very encouraging. And now I am spending a lot of time on these things. Whatever administrative role I can let off, I kind of move away from the administrative roles as much as possible, but there are certain things I cannot avoid. So I continue to chair the IQAC, the quality cell of our university campus. Earlier I was doing it for all the campuses, but now because of this hackathons and thing, I just came out. And the last 2 years, I'm also actively involved in mentoring the schools. So the Niti Aayog, the planning commission, has appointed me as one of the regional mentors, that which I coordinate the school level tinkering labs in almost 600 to 700 schools in Tamil Nadu, which are under the Atal Innovation Mission. All over India, there may be something like 10,000 schools with Atal Tinkering Labs, but I'm kind of coordinating the Tamil Nadu aspect of it. And there, last 2 years, I'm also mentoring students for schools. So my mentoring journey has been very amazing. And from 2017 onwards, barely three to four years, very actively involved in mentoring student teams, the results have been phenomenal, in the sense that almost 50 plus hackathon victories and top ranks, means around 10 hackathons we have won it. We have come number one in 10 hackathons, and another 30 to 40 hackathons we have been ranked in the top. In the sense that maybe in the top 5, in the top 3, in the top 10, top 15. In some very major international hackathons, we have also come in the top 100 and all. That is global, all over the world and all. So it's a very exciting journey that in the last 3 to 4 years, 50 plus hackathon victories and top ranks. And among them, Smart India Hackathon in 2018, we won it for the, my student team won it for the Ministry of Commerce and Industry. We won the Rajasthan Hackathon. We won the TCS NGINX Digital Twin Challenge. This is perhaps the hackathon with the or contest with the highest prize money. It has a prize money of 5 lakhs. I think it is the highest, and we won that in 2018. We have also gone international in a very big way. In 2019, we won the IEEE Asia Pacific Humanitarian Technology Challenge. We have beaten teams from China, Japan, Australia, Singapore, and other countries in this Asia. We have won this prestigious IEEE Asia Pacific Humanitarian Technology Challenge in 2019. In fact, this victory happened in Indonesia. We had gone to Indonesia last year, around the same time, around November, we were in Indonesia and we won that. And another, I would say, the crowning glory, we couldn't win this, but we could represent India as part of the national hackathon team by Ministry of Education for the Singapore India Hackathon 2018. And we came in the top 5 teams of this hackathon. We represented the India, and as mentioned in my profile, you will see an image. Our team is there with the Prime Minister of India, who felicitated us in Singapore. Actually, he was there in Singapore for the ASEAN summit, and since this idea was given by the Prime Minister to have the Singapore India hackathon, he spent some time with all of us. We had a photo opportunity, and we could have a shake hand, an interaction in a group. So it was an amazing, inspiring experience, especially when you are representing your country. You know, the feeling is really amazing, and we were truly inspired. Of course, we had 20 teams representing the country in the Singapore India Hackathon. There were 2 teams from Amrita. All the other teams were from top IITs or Indian Institute of Science. Only there were 3 or 4 private universities and colleges. And I'm very happy to tell you that, you know, our team came in the top 5 also, beating several IIT and IAC teams. There were a couple of IIT teams above us, but we did pretty well, along with only 3 or 4 colleges had some private institutions. So it was an amazing journey, so as to speak. And this journey continues. This in 2020 also, one of my teams, I have not put it in this slide, my teams was in the final of the Technology Infusion Grand Challenge in Melbourne. We were supposed to go, but unfortunately, because of the pandemic, Australia is completely closed. So we couldn't go for the pitch in Melbourne. It was supposed to happen around December, but unfortunately, because of pandemic, it's cancelled. We also another team has was supposed to travel to Malaysia also for the this year's humanitarian technology challenge, but unfortunately that event became virtual and they scrapped all the student events. So it really affected us in a very big way. But the journey continues. This year we won one online. We won a hackathon of IIT Bombay Skylab Toolbox hackathon, which we won this year. And in Smart India Hackathon also we came third in one of the this thing. So the journey is continuing. I have another team already in the top 100 of the KPIT Sparkle Hackathon. We are due for doing a pitch next week. I have another team participating IEEE Maker Faire event happening as we speak, and we are in the finals and we are keeping our fingers crossed. So the journey is continuing. At one point of time, I had 7 hackathon teams. Now, because of the pandemic, I have around 3-4 teams which are very actively. Actually, all 7 are there, but 3 or 4 are only very actively involved. Some of them are into placement, but the journey is continuing. Next year, I will take. I'm very selective in taking teams, so I have to be very confident that they gel with me. So probably next year, once the pandemic is over, I will take more teams for the hackathon. Now, coming to the school level thing, I've got involved only in the last 2 years, I am actually mentoring a school in Coimbatore called Yuvabharati School, and that school I'm helping them with respect to several competitions. They work a lot on IoT projects, and I'm trying to help them in IoT projects. So in fact, they won that Coimbatore Kovai Vira or something, Coimbatore. The team had won the competition also, and not only that, my other mentoring activities have been very much recognized by strategic mentoring activities have been very much recognized by Planning Commission, Niti Aayog, and Atal Innovation Mission, and I've been recognized as the top mentor many times. And there are some of the this is what I was telling you. Coimbatore Science and Technology Festival 2019. My team won the prize. So they worked on IoT, and I'm very proud to be guiding them. In fact, we are also applying for a patent. The school children are applying for a patent in that area also. Now, coming to the tips and the so on. What is a hackathon? You know, many of us confuse hackathon something hacking into the system. Nothing like that. Hackathon has nothing to do with hacking into the system, hacking into or doing any unethical thing. Hackathon is a very innovative, a very creative, a very fun activity. So it has absolutely, first thing I want to tell you is hackathon has nothing to do with hacking. Hacking is an unethical thing where you are trying to look for vulnerabilities in a system. You are looking for weaknesses and trying to exploit the weaknesses in any system, software or hardware or network. You are trying to look for vulnerabilities and deficiencies. But hackathon is nothing like that. Hackathon is you are trying to build something which is creative, which is innovative, which solves a problem, which tries to help the society. And at the most important aspect of it is that you get your hands dirty. You get your hands dirty with focusing on building something, and it's a lot of fun. So that's the idea of a hackathon. Hackathon has nothing to do with hacking. You're building something innovative. You're building something, making your hands dirty. You're building, solving a problem. You're unleashing your creativity, your teamwork, your innovation. And you are applying all your skills, your knowledge into developing something that is innovative, that is creative, that is fun. And you are unleashing your creativity, your teamwork, your innovation. So the definition of a hackathon is it is a digital product development. But the catch is that you are building this digital product. Digital product means it's a combination. There will be some hardware, there will be some software, there will be some interfacing between the hardware and the software. There could be an application which will be portable. It may be available on an app. It may be available on the computer. It may be available on a device, and so on. So this, you are building a digital product, but that product is made in a very limited time. That is the essence of a hacker. You are building a digital product, but it is being built in a very limited time. And generally speaking, hackathons are, you know, could be less than 24 hours, 48 hours, 72 hours. I don't think any hackathon is beyond 72 hours. Primarily, most hackathons are between 24 to 36 hours, maximum 48 hours. There are a few grueling hackathons that are 72 hours and so on. So you are building a digital product, but that digital product is being built in a very small amount of time, less than 24 hours, 18 hours, 16 hours, 24 hours, 48 hours, maximum 72 hours. And the catch is that you are applying all your knowledge, you are applying all your skills, you are applying all your knowledge of technology, software, hardware, and you are applying your creativity, you are applying your innovation, you are applying your teamwork, and building a product, a digital product that solves a problem. That is the general objective of a hackathon. So in most hackathons, at least 99% of the hackathons, the actual problem statement is given much ahead of schedule. Basic idea is usually given ahead of schedule. And also the basic specifications are also given ahead of schedule, meaning that, you know, this is the problem statement and these are the things that we require. Generally, they give you a very limited problem statement. They do not give much of details. Only the basic specifications are generally given ahead of schedule. But when you go for the hackathon, generally they give you more details about the hackathon. So you have some fairly good idea what you have to do. And see, you know, they say, no, well begun is half done. So you have to do your homework. Otherwise, because they have given you the specification, they have given you the problem statement, you need to start working on it ahead of schedule, not during the hackathon. You have to do it much ahead of schedule and plan for things. So simply speaking, I wanted to summarize this slide. A hackathon is nothing to do with hacking. It is not an unethical thing. Hackathon is building a digital product. And that digital product solves a problem, solves a major problem, number one. This digital product has to be developed in a very limited amount of time. It could be 10 hours, 12 hours, 18 hours, 24 hours, 48 hours, and 72 hours. Primarily, most hackathons are within 36 hours, mostly. The most popular hackathons, they judge you within 36 hours. And the catch is that you are doing the entire product life cycle in that 24 hours or 36 hours. Meaning, you are having an idea. Of course, you know the idea ahead of schedule, but that idea you are conceptualizing, you are building a prototype, you are executing, you are testing, and finally pitching also. You are pitching the product to the stakeholders, and all this happens in a very limited time frame, 24 hours or 18 hours or 48 hours or 72 hours and so on. And hackathon is a lot of fun because you're unleashing your creativity, your teamwork, your innovation, you're applying all the knowledge that you gained, you're applying the skills that you gained, applying the software that you learned, applying the hardware that you are capable, you know, and you're applying it to solve this digital product development. That is the meaning of a hackathon. Now, what I'm going to say is only tips, you know, that things that helped us a lot. You know, the first step is having a good team. Hack is not a single man's or woman's game. It is a good team has to be formed. Now, the team, let me be very clear. A team has got nothing to do with friendship. The very definition of a team, in fact, the expansion of a team is that together everybody achieves more, number one. The very definition of a team is that it is a group of people with complementary skills. That is the meaning. It's nothing to do with friendship. But yes, once you form a team, it is important that you gel well, you vibe well, you work together as a team. So a team has to have, when you form a good team, you should have people with very good complementary skills. If you are going for a programming contest and they specify programming contest is using machine learning and Java. Then obviously you need somebody who's adept in Java, somebody who's adept in machine learning algorithms, the logic, and somebody who knows the machine learning software like Keras or deep learning software. So you form the team based on the skill set. The skill set has to be complementary. If one person is very strong in coding, the other fellow should be strong in pitching. If one fellow is very good in machine learning, the other fellow should be probably good in data structure. So like that, form a team with complementary skills, and the complementary skills are needed. So what I do is, I have a pool. I told you I have 4 or 5 hackathon teams. But there is no question of permanency. If I want, I mix and match the teams. I'll say A from this team. See, normally I don't do that. Normally there is a hackathon team form, I use the same team. But whenever needed, I have taken skills from outside. I have done mixing and matching. See, suppose TCS NGINX needs a lot of machine learning. So I brought an extra member from another team that I was hacking and formed a new team. Not a new team, I mixed it and matched my team because I needed somebody who was good in cloud, somebody who was good in IoT, somebody who was good in pitching, and somebody who was good in machine learning. So that 4-member team, and the some teams, some hackathons say 4 people, 6 people, 3 people, 5 people, 2 people. So depending upon that, there is no holy cow. You have to mix and match. Depending upon the hackathon, you may have to regroup and make new teams. As I mentioned, it is not friendship. It is about winning the problem, winning the solution. And as a mentor, I am able to very seamlessly mix and match. And there are no ego issues. If I say that, you know, I want this guy and that guy, the students of all the teams know who is important, who is good, who has got the talent, and so on and so forth. So that is the thing. And once you form a team, then you have to gel. Together, everybody achieves more. You need to have good group dynamics. You need to vibe well. Maybe you don't know each other so well, but that's the different thing. In a limited time, you are supposed to gel well. You should be able to work properly. And always the team effort is more important. Individual effort is there. I don't deny that. There is definitely individual brilliance, but the individual brilliance has to take a back seat with respect to the team performance. You see, many a time you are doing a project review. Each of you are trying to outdo the other person. Yeah, I did most of the work, so I want to project it. That is a totally wrong attitude. If you might have done all the work for the team, right? Others might not have done. An intelligent guide or an intelligent faculty member who is evaluating you will be able to find it out. You don't have to tell that. But in the process, what happens is that you try to outdo your teammates, and what happens? You also lose, they also lose. So the team effort, the team performance, the team ambition, the team aspiration is paramount. Your individual brilliance and individual contribution has to be going to the backdrop. If there is a victory, maybe you might have contributed, you know. Like, you know, in a football match or a cricket match, there is a man of the match. But it's a team effort, right? It's a team effort. You know, I want to, you know, talk about Sachin Tendulkar. You know, he's the greatest, the god of cricket, the Bharat Ratna Sachin Tendulkar. He had, individual, all the records were this. But when you saw the World Cup game, you could catch on the television in 2011 when India won the World Cup, you could see there was a tear in his eyes because he never won the World Cup, and he probably didn't contribute so much to the final, but he was the happiest person on the earth, and the entire team was then, we won this for Sachin, because he, it is the team that matters. So that kind of team dynamics is very important. You form a team, you have to vibe well, you have to have good understanding, you have to gel well, you have to adjust with each other, you have to work with each other, and generally all of you have complementary skills, so the team will be able to work together, multiple talent, multiple facets, and when there is a victory, it is everybody's victory. When there is a defeat, it is everybody's defeat. It's not like saying that, you know, I worked very hard, but we lost. Others didn't contribute. That's not at all the thing. That the whole purpose of the team is defeated. So that is the general. And it always helps that you have a nice catchy team name. You know, it's always very good to have a good team name. Now identify the correct contest, the right contest. There are so many contests happening every day, right? Every day some contest is happening. You know, you go to HackerRank or HackerEarth.com, HackerRank.com, DareToCompete.com, you look at Facebook, you look at Instagram, you will be seeing so many competitions happening. You cannot participate in all of them. Let's be very honest about it. You cannot participate in all of them. You cannot win them all. Rather, you focus on the ones that suits your skill set. When I say your skill set, it is not your skill set, it is the team skill set. So if your team, if you find a hackathon that is focused on image processing, you're not good in image processing, you don't have anybody who has done neural networks and training and neural stuff, don't go for it. But you find a hackathon that is into app development and you have done a lot of apps. So you look for the contest, but you have to be on the lookout. Always be on the lookout for websites like HackerRank, HackerEarth, DareToCompete.com and so on. And when these contests happen, you can look for all them continuously. Watch out for proper contests and go for the one that suits your skill set. And it's not your skill set, it is a team skill set, which your team will be able to crack. So the platform is now available. This is the first step. Now, generally, all hackathons have a kind of a sifting or a filtering process is there. Generally, the hackathon will just give you a basic problem statement and a basic idea. They will not divulge too many things. It will be intentionally vague. There will be a very, generally they give that. And they ask you to give an abstract for the for that problem statement. I'll give you an example. Smart transportation. This will be the theme of the hackathon. Smart transportation. Now, from the smart transportation theme, you have to build a problem statement. You can decide, I can develop a smart helmet using IoT and machine learning for smart transportation. One thing. You can have an AR or VR solution to ensure that drivers are safe during driving. And that can be embedded in your, not in the helmet, but in your spectacles. You can have spectacles for that. So they have only given you a broad idea, smart transportation, but that you need to elucidate and make it into a simple, a clear problem statement. Mind you, this problem statement should not be a story. It should be very crisp. Now, you look at Twitter. You know, in Twitter, all the great leaders use Twitter, right? Twitter is, give your message in 280 or 240 characters. The whole message you have to give in that 240 characters. So you should think like that. When people talk about Donald Trump, the Donald Trump used to do diplomacy using 4 years. See, whether you love him or you hate him, that's a different thing. You can't ignore the guy. He was the world's most powerful leader and he ran his whole presidency using Twitter. He puts a strong message. You know, the thing is done. So he has leveraged the power of social media. I'm not saying what he did is right or wrong. What I'm saying is that he leveraged the power of Twitter, giving short, powerful messages. So that kind of, very clear, concise problem statements you have to write. I'm giving an example. To provide a solution towards minimizing the frequent navigation checks using mobile during bike and car ride. It's just 20 words or 20 or 15 words are there, but the message is clearly given. So have that kind of crisp problem statement, which is not very long, which conveys your idea and clearly addresses the problem that you want to solve. Make it very crisp. Now, when you are giving the problem statement, back it up. Back it up with clear requirements. Why this need is there? Oh, there are this many accidents happening. So because of that, we want to make smart transportation is needed because this many this many accidents are happening, this many people are dying, this many thing, and who is telling? Wall Street Journal is telling this many accidents are happening. Times of India is telling that this many accidents are happening. Rediff.com is mentioning that every year this many people are dying due to bike accidents. Like that, back your problem statement up. Add the veracity of the problem statement with clear sources, and these sources should have numbers, should have infographics ideally. Everybody has to likes to see pictures, chart, graph, images, stats, infographics, so that the message is given, rather than writing long stories. If you are able to give a problem statement, a small problem statement, have a graphical infographic, this is the need for this problem, and we want to address this problem. Why this problem is so relevant? Because this is the reason so many people are dying, so many people are suffering, and we are trying to address that problem. So that is a very important aspect of the hackathon. You are giving a nice problem statement, crisp problem statement, which addresses the problem, conveys the idea, and you add it with stats and figures, you add the justification, you add the scope, you add a simple architecture diagram with what are the components of this. But if you can, rather than writing a story, if you can put it in the form of an infographic, a dashboard kind of thing, nothing like it. So this is the first step. So every hackathon will only give a vague problem statement, smart transportation. You have to build it into a understandable problem statement. You have to be crisp. You have to give the idea. You have to give infographics. You have to back it up with references, with numbers, facts and figures. Give a simple architectural diagram with the components. Give a simple justification, and ideally that can be in the form of a infographic, a chart, a picture, and so on and so forth. Now you have to build the solution. Now once you have submitted the abstract, they would have looked into your abstract. They would have got thousands and thousands of abstracts. They would have just chosen a few of them, maybe 100 or 200 or 50 or 10 or 20. Now you have been selected. First step is that you have already, please understand, there is a lot of homework. Once you have been selected, now you have to go and demonstrate it. You need to get the components. You need to keep things ready. You need to understand how to plan the time. You know that the hackathon is 24 hours or 48 hours or 72 hours. Before you go there, you should have a clarity. How will you spend the 24 hours? So you take all the components, you go for the hackathon, you have reached the spot, they have had an inauguration, they have finished everything, and the hack begins. Now you have 24 hours, you have 42 hours, you have 72 hours. How do you spend this time? Don't go to the wire. Go down the wire. Go down the wire means if you have 24 hours, don't plan for 24 hours. Plan for 16 hours. You are going to complete everything in 16 hours. Target not too many things to be solved in 24 hours. Mind you have already done your homework. Now you have 24 hours to complete the challenge. Ensure that you plan to complete it in 16 hours. Give each person his or her role. You should not interfere into each other. If you say you do this module, none of us should interfere. Each person should be given the role. Each person should be given the module. Each person should be given the milestone and say that the hack begins now. All of us have to complete this in the next 12 hours. After 12 hours, we will each of us will complete, and the next 4 hours, we will integrate, complete, test, and do everything. So in 16 hours, your challenge is completed. I will tell you why the hack is 24 hours, but you have to complete in 16 hours. The reason is, in between, there will be formal judging and informal judging. Many a time the judges will walk together and ask you questions. That is where they maximum they understand what you are doing. Because when you are doing a pitch, maybe after 8 hours you have to do the first pitch. You have to explain the idea. That time they are no doubt they are judging, but even informally they are judging. And when they are informally judging, they may give you some ideas. After 8 hours, when you do the first pitch for the 24-hour hackathon, they will give you ideas. And based on those ideas, you will have to change. You will have to customize your product, your project, your thing, you have to customize, you have to add features, you have to do this, you have to consider these inputs. So in this process, what is happening is you cannot plan for 24 hours. You have to plan for 12 hours or 16 hours or so on. And the remaining 8 hours is needed for adding the suggestions, adding the inputs, adding the features that have been suggested by the judges, either informally or formally during the pitches. I hope you understand what I'm trying to say. In fact, I will tell you, the best pitch, the best one, when you have completed everything and you are going for the hackathon, it doesn't happen that way. But if you are very clear, you have completed everything and then you go there, the only thing you need to do is show the judges and take the inputs from the judges, take the feedback from the judges, and then go on tweaking the project and do on. And when you pitch, make it short. Be very clear. This is what it is. This is the selling point. Be very, very honest about it. Be very honest. It doesn't help that you say, oh, my software is great, I will do that, I can do that, I will do this, I will do. These things don't work. They are very smart and intelligent people. They will figure out that you are just speculating, or you are only exaggerating. They will easily be able to find out. So be honest about it. If they say, okay, can you do this? You be very honest, sir. No, we can't do this. Even this feature cannot be added even towards the end of the hack. It will take 2 months to do this feature. We will definitely do it in the next, when we are developing this product next time. But during this hack, we may not be able to do it. Be very honest about it. And make sure the hardware is clearly fabricated, software is well written with the coding guidelines, having the documentation. Make it very crisp. Ideally, you know, you don't have 100 slides and all. Have 3 or 4 slides. Put a demo in a video. Even for the first pitch, I will say. First pitch also, I will tell. You know, when you're doing the first pitch itself, have a small short video and I try to explain. Have very few slides. And it's not needed that all of you should present. It can be done by one person or something. Right? Everybody need not present. The person who can communicate effectively, very crisply. And when there are questions, the others can answer so that somebody did the machine learning person can answer. Somebody did the IoT, that IoT sensor part, that fellow can answer. So you should gel as a team, not that everybody should present. People think, okay, now I will talk, now he will talk, now she will talk. This, the flow is lost. Ideally, one or two people should present. That's my personal experience, like I told you, my personal experience is like that. In some cases, as a mentor, even I have pitched. You know, that has happened. Some cases, the students were not able to think. I have very convincingly been able to present. They have asked questions. What are you going to do? The answer is there. So generally, all hackathons, these first pitches, if there is a 24-hour hackathon, there may be 2 pitches in between after the 8th hour and the 16th hour. Not only these formal pitches, but the informal questions that they ask you are also important. So you are all the time working on the product. Once you have this, they normally shortlist a few teams for the power round or the final round. And generally, the shortlisting is based on, these are only some ideas. You know, they look for the originality, the novelty, the usefulness of the product, the completion of the project, all the features being added, the usefulness in the sense that whether it is actually solving a problem or whether it is a redundant information, whether it is whether this product or project can be converted into a product and it can be sold in the market, whether a startup can come out of this, what is the presentation, your presentation, like I mentioned, all of you present, it just doesn't, the flow is lost, one or two people, there is clarity, when you are presenting, and all of you are contributing, if a question is asked, the other fellow will answer, that kind of clarity you have to bring, relevance to the hackathon team, and whether there is a societal context, whether there is a business interest, whether it can be converted to a startup, whether it can be, these are the things that they look for. So, these have to be contributed, and please note that judging happens round the clock. And as I mentioned, if there is a pitch in 8th hour and 16th hour, they are actually judging you even during the other time also, informally they are thinking. So judging is not actually the presentation time. You may think, oh, okay, I will only prepare everything when they come. When they come also, you should have a good answer to talk to them. So these are simple things. These are all simple, what should I say, commonsensical things that have helped us. Once you are shortlisted, you have a much bigger challenge waiting for you in the finals when the power judging happens. Power judging is generally very, very short. Maximum 7 minutes. Even 7 minutes is very, very high. If you ask me, I lose when I am judging Smart India Hackathon. I've been a judge for both hardware and software. All the students who were there when I was judging know that I expect a presentation for 3 or 4 minutes. Beyond that, I get bugged. Nobody has time. Right? Everybody is busy. And when you are doing a judging, you don't want all the stories. You talk about what you have done. What is your product? How it has helped? How it has helped society? What is the plan moving forward? What is the scope of the project? And all these things. So the maximum 7 minutes. In the 7 minutes, you should talk about what the product is, what is the motivation, what is the business need, what is the societal need, what is the architecture, which technology that you have used, which is the, and have a, in fact, in the 7 minutes, ideally you can have, say, a 3 to 4 minute presentation and a 2 minute video, so that that 7 minutes are taken care. It's a pitch. And have a good PPT with the video should be there for 2 minutes, maybe 3 to 5 minutes per PPT. PPT should have more of graphics and infographics. You put too much of clutter, test, everybody gets bugged. Have practice before that. And ideally, one person or two people should do the pitch. Others can answer questions. That's the best idea. That is the best thing. So it's a pitch. And before you do the pitch, practice. Practice, rehearse. I do that all the time, you know. Word by word I do. I call my teams. I take the person who is going to present outside from the, and I sit with that and do a rehearsal, find out what is happening. And some cases, you know, it didn't work out and I had to do the pitch. That things have also happened sometimes. The presenter should be very clear in what he or she says, have a clear idea about the entire project. But if they don't know, they can always say that I don't know, I don't know the thing, and I will get back to you, and so on. Have a good presence of mind, answer the questions, add some humor, some jokes, but the joke should be very palatable, and so on. And also always check before the pitch whether your PPT is working, whether your video is working, whether it has been properly copied, whether the projector is working, all these things in the end. You cannot be doing these things. Now, when the pitch is happening, and also when the informal, not only the power judging, when any judging is happening, listen to the questions that the judges are asking. Do not jump the gun. Listen patiently. Answer the questions that they are asking you. If you do not know the answer, please tell, I don't know. There is no point in beating around the bush and exaggerating. It doesn't help you. Be honest about it. Tell and be very honest. You know, sir, this feature is not there. I'm sorry, but we will do it. We can't do it in the next 3-4 hours, but we will do it soon. And at the end of the presentation, say thanks. Thanks to the thing. They have given you a wonderful opportunity to showcase your innovation. They have given you an opportunity to showcase your innovation in a public forum. You are one selected among the top. And that itself is a victory. Maybe you may or may not win the hackathon, but you are already reached that stage. It is a victory. And be very, thank them for that. Thank all the other finalists and, wish everybody the best. Thank the judges because they have spent their time. They may be working in a company. They may be working in a factory. They may be working in a research agency, they may be working in a university, and they have spent time to be with you, to judge you. Thank them, and that's all from my side. May you all win the next hack. We have so many interesting. I hope these simple ideas are useful to one and all, and I hope all more than 100 of you are here. I hope all of you go on to win several hacks. Wish you all the best. I'll be happy to answer some questions if you have any. Thank you. Over to you, Dinesh and organizers.
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir. That's very, very wonderful, sir. Amazing to be with you. And all, it's always a pleasure to hear you, sir. So thank you so much for the wonderful session. And we are really amazed. We are really amazed of your achievements, sir. We wish you to have many more success. And we wish to follow the guidelines that your experience, which you have shared with us, will definitely help us. And I'm happy to share with you that our team, our college, we, our one team on under Ministry of Communication, have won Smart India Hackathon Grand Finale 2020 last year, sir. So as this, we had already initiated, made our first step. With this experience sharing and with this guidelines, definitely our students will make a many more a presentation, appearance, and prize winning contest, sir. So thank you very much for this session, sir.
Yeah, thank you so much. I'll be happy to answer any queries if you have. You have recorded it. I will request you, Dinesh, if you can send me the video.
Also. Yeah, definitely, sir. I'll send you the video, sir. Sure, sir. Yeah. So, dear students, if you have any queries, you can definitely ask, sir.
You can come online or put on the chat box. Either way is fine.
Dear students, if you got any queries, you can ask now, or you can even write it in your chat box.
I think one question from Tejaswini.
Yes, sir.
What if we are at the beginning level? What can we do to improve our skills? If you ask me, everybody is a beginner. You cannot go on saying that I'm always there. All of us are at a beginning stage. And see, if you ask me something about, Firebase. And I don't know anything about Firebase. I know it's something to do with cloud. If I have to do something in Firebase, I have to study Firebase. So the only way to improve our skills is practice, practice, practice. That's the answer. Practice, practice, practice. Improve your skills. You don't know something, you have to master it. You have to read it, study it, try it out. Now, as I mentioned, generally speaking, most of my hackathon teams have got very fast successes. First time we came, we have won. Second time we came, but there have been one or two teams where there have been some issues. Maybe they started winning after the third or fourth hackathon, and every single time they were very upset that they came to tell me, "Sir, we didn't win. Your other teams are winning. We are so sorry." I said, "There's nothing like that. It's all luck. There are so many factors that are beyond me and beyond you. We try our pitch. We try our level best." Sometimes they work, sometimes they don't work. See, because ultimately we make a product, and the product we may think is very, very good. But just give me a minute. Yeah, I have a class actually. I've just delayed the class. Sorry. So there is absolutely the only way to, from a beginner to an expert is practice, practice, practice. And every single time we improve. And let me say, there is a very popular saying, fortune favors the brave. You be brave, you practice, you do your part. The remaining thing, it's not for you to judge or decide. It will happen. That is my experience. And in fact, I wanted to personally also, given experience. See, as far as Singapore India Hackathon was concerned, I had the best team. That I can tell you, that team won so many hackathons. It had, even Indian Express had a special feature calling them the best hackathon team in India, because they won Rajasthan Hackathon, Smart India Hackathon, another 2-3 hackathons. I don't even remember the names. They were one of the best teams in India, and Indian Express and Times of India have featured that team. And we were selected to represent India in Smart India, in Singapore India Hackathon. We went to Singapore. You can't believe it. We came in the top 5. There were probably 10 IIT teams below us. We came in the top 5, but it was like a disaster for my teammate. And they somehow thought we should have come first. First was a very big stretch. We were nowhere near the top team. We knew that also. And the second team, we were looking at second, but somehow they only declared first and second prize. Third and fourth, fifth, they didn't mention. So we were so upset. Students were upset. I was telling them, what is it, dude? You have represented the country. You have come to the top 5 of an international hackathon. You are in the national hackathon team. But they were maha upset. They were so upset. I don't know what time was it was. We were, the results were declared. You know what I did? I don't know what time. I called up the dean and told him, probably he was sleeping. I don't know what time it was also. And I told them, see, I am not able to. What I'm saying is, the dean of the university who's taking care of 6,000 students, we had a con call, and, after that, my team was okay. I had to do that because they were very upset. And let me tell you that, after this, and the next day, we could meet the Prime Minister of the country, and what else you need, we came back very happy. So sometimes disappointments happen, but the only thing is to get out of the disappointment. If you go on brooding and about the disappointment, you will reach nowhere. The best thing is to move on. And I have a very detached attitude. Once I completed the hack, I gave all the information to the university. It came on the Facebook page. It came on the website. I immediately detach and move on to the next challenge. That is my strategy. And I try to tell my students also to focus on that. You shouldn't be too much swayed by either success or defeat. You should move on. You should be detached from that. You finish the work, then move on to the next challenge. That is always my attitude. I finish it, I post it on Facebook, I forget about it and move on. That's my attitude. So that's how you should improve your skills by practice, and never ever be deterred by success or failure. Success is good. Enjoy it for a night. The next day you move on. Same way for failure. Move on to the next challenge. Another question from Dharani, how can I choose the idea? See, the idea is, again, you can choose your idea based on what you are strong at. As I mentioned, you can always use the e-resources. Look into the Smart India Hackathon website. You will find so many ideas and problems. From there, you read, you evaluate, you deliberate, you discuss, and from there, you will get the idea, right? There is a next question is, what can we do to be one of the best teams in hackathon? I already told you that, first step is forming a good team. That is the best team, forming a good team for the competition. And you should be in such a way that, once you form the team, participate in a hackathon. If there is another hackathon on a different team, you need to change the team. But there's nothing wrong in that. And elaborating the ideas, make it short. Whatever idea you are pitching, whether it is for a judge for in the first pitch or in the final power pitch, make it very crisp, very, very short and sweet and short and crisp. And use as much as infographics for the presentation. So this is how you can elaborate your ideas. Rather than telling stories, you should be very crisp, to the point. One, I told you, anything more than 4 or 5 slides, I'm not comfortable. I want to do everything in 4 or 5 slides. That's my strategy. Maximum 4 or 5 slides, you pitch it nicely and you know, you're able to do things. I think, Dinesh, there are no more ideas. I think we can close. There are no more questions. I think we can close. No, you're mute. You're muted, Dinesh. You're muted.
Hello, sir.
Yeah. I can now see you. Yeah.
Yes, sir. So last year many teams have participated, sir, and obviously this year we'll encourage them, we'll motivate, and we'll give awareness for, like, along with these sessions. And definitely this year we definitely will come back to you again, sir, if we have any queries or any help regarding.
Yeah, please feel free to do that. No problem.
Definitely, sure. Definitely, sir. And thank you so much for accepting our invitation, sir. Thank you so much, sir.
Okay, thank you. Wish you all the best to all the students. Hope you guys, you folks win the next hack. Thank you. Bye bye. See you.
Thank you, sir. Students, ana feedback link potrukken group la chat box la feedback link irukku, ellarum adha fill panidunga.